In this session, we will study about the isomerism. The word isomerism first introduced by Mr. Berzelius. And in Greek, iso means same or equal. Same or equal. And meros means parts. So we can define isomerism as same molecular formula but different structural formula. The compounds which have same molecular formula but different structural formula are said to be isomers of each other, and the phenomenon is known as isomerism. Now we'll try to first understand the classification of isomerism. Isomerism, first it is classified into two groups. Structural isomer and second one is stereoisomers. Structural isomers and stereoisomers. Now, structural isomers are further classified as chain isomer, then position isomer, then ring isomer, metamers, and tautomers, But stereoisomers are further classified as configurational isomer and conformational isomer. Once more, stereoisomers are further classified as configurational isomer and second one is conformational isomer. Now, configurational isomers are further classified as geometrical isomer, and optical isomer. Now we will understand isomerism, that is structural isomers, in detail. Structural isomerism first we will study position isomerism. Take example of CH3 CH2 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 OH. This is butane one on. But by changing the position of functional group, we can get butane 2-ol. So these are the position isomers, we can say, because the position of functional group is different in both the cases. Now for butene, we have this compound is butene, but if we keep double bond between carbon 1 and 2, then it is but-1-ene. Same way for triple bond. If this compound we speak, then it is but-1-ine. And this compound is but-2-ine. So these are said to be position isomerism. Same way for aromatic compound. Two OH group on adjacent position, then it is said to be 1,2 dihydroxy derivative. Same way, 1,3 dihydroxy derivative and third possibility is 1,4 dihydroxy derivative. So these are aromatic compounds in which we can find out the position isomerism. Now we will study chain isomerism. Second, chain isomerism. Take example of any alkene, say pentane. This is normal pentane. We can write this pentane in this way also. This is also the case of normal pentane. Now from this normal pentane, another structure possible having same formula, molecular formula, but different structural formula is this one, and this is 2-methyl butane. Common name is, because of this functional group iso, it is also known as isopentane. This is also known as isopentane. Now we will study chain isomerism for hexane. For hexane. Formula of hexane, by simply writing with using carbon atoms only, we can write this is to be normal hexane. Normal hexane. From this, another structure which is possible is isohexane. Isohexane. Or IUPAC name is 2-methyl pentane. 2-methyl pentane. Another possibility is this one. This is known as neopentane, neohexane, because of 6 carbon. We can write neohexane. But IUPAC name will be 2,2-dimethyl butane. 2,2-dimethyl butane. Now we will also find another structure which is also having same formula, C6H14, same molecular formula, C6H14. This is known as 2,3-dimethyl butane. Same way, one more structure is also possible. So these are the chain isomers of hexane, same way we have written here for the pentane. As the carbon number increases, the number of chain isomers also increases. Ring chain isomers. Ring chain isomerism, taking example of prop1-in, or simply say propene. Propene and cyclopropane we can say these are the example of ring chain isomer functional group isomers. These are the isomers having different functional groups, and that is why the word utilized here is functional group isomerism. First we will see alcohols, and ethers. Take example of ethyl alcohol, C2H5OH, ethanol and CH3OCH3, dimethyl ether. Why these are said to be functional group isomers? Because ethyl alcohol contains alcohol functional group and dimethyl ether contains functional group ether. Now we can check, both have same molecular formula but having different functional group. So molecular formula is C2H6O, and for dimethyl ether also C2H6O. That is why they are said to be functional group isomers. Now after alcohols and ethers, we have aldehydes and ketones. Molecular formula C3H6O, aldehyde possible is CH3CH2CHO. It is propanol. This is the structural formula of propanol. But for ketone, it will be acetone or propane 2-on. These are said to be again functional group isomers to each other because different functional group, aldehyde and ketone, are present in both the structure. Now we will study, both have same molecular formula C3H6O. C, here we can calculate 3, hydrogen 6 and 1 oxygen. Same way here also we have 3 carbon, 6 hydrogen and 1 oxygen. Now third category, acids and esters. One of the best example of functional group isomer in which acid group and ester functional group is present. Acetic acid, or IUPAC name is ethanoic acid. HCOOCH3, this is methyl formate. This functional group is CH3, that is why methyl, and because of one carbon it is known as formator. So we will decide whether this proves functional group isomerism or not. CH3COOH, functional group is COOH, and in methyl format the functional group is COO. Now we will also find that whether they have same molecular formula or not. So here we can say total number of carbon atoms in both, 2 carbon, 2 carbon. hydrogen 4, here also hydrogen 4. So C2H4 and number of oxygens are 2. That is why they have general formula C2H4O2, and both have different functional group, and that is why they are said to be functional group isomer. Now, nitro group or nitrite, nitro group or nitrite, we take example of C2H5NO2. This is nitroethane. This is nitroethane. But if we write it C2H5ONO, then it is ethyl nitrite. This is known as ethyl nitrite. That is why these are also said to be functional group isomers. Now we will study metamers. Metamerism, or simple language we speak metamers. Take example of pentanone, CH3, CH2, COO, CH2, CH3. This is pentane to a pentane trion, because ketone group is present on third number carbon atom, that is why pentane trion. Same way, if we write pentane 2-on, then these are said to be metamers to each other. Now, first we will study why they are said to be metamers to each other. First, we say functional group ketone is present. On both its side, we have alkyl chain. Alkyl chain. This is ethyl. Here also it is ethyl. So we can say diethyl ketone. Diethyl ketone. But if we consider this example, then it is one side methyl alkyl chain is present, and another side we have propyl chain present. That is why it is methyl propyl ketone. So pentane 3-on and pentane 2-on will be the example for metamer. CH3, CH2, O, CH2, CH2, CH3. So, this is the case of ether. This is the case of ether. Here we have one side ethyl alkyl chain and another side we have propyl chain. This one is propyl and this is ethyl. So this is di case of ethyl propyl ether. Ethyl propyl ether. But by changing the alkyl chain, we get one side only methyl alkyl chain and another side butyl. So this will be now butyl methyl ether. So again we can say that this will be the case of metamers. Now we will understand tautomerism. In Greek, tauto means same, and meros means parts. It means tautomerism is equal to, we can say, according to Greek, same parts. First of all, we will understand its definition. What is the definition of tautomers and tautomerism? If a substance exists in two different forms, first of all we think about ketone and enol. So one form is ketone form and second one is enol form. So these two exist in two different forms and they are interconvertible into each other, as well as there is an equilibrium between both the compounds, then they are said to be tautomers of each other, and the phenomenon is known as tautomerism. Let us decide what are the conditions for tautomerism. Conditions for tautomerism. First condition, there should be electron withdrawing group present in organic molecule like nitro, cyanide or ketone. Then only tautomerism is possible. Out of different tautomerism, keto-enol tautomerism is very well known, in which there should be at least one alpha hydrogen atom present, then only keto-enol tautomerism becomes possible. So based on this condition, we can say if we have the molecule of benzaldehyde in which there is no alpha hydrogen present, it means we can say that benzaldehyde cannot show tautomerism. Same way in the case of diphenyl ketone, also we can say that is there is no possibility of tautomerism. Diphenyl ketone is PHCOPH. Because of lacking of alpha hydrogen, or we can say alpha hydrogen is absent, that is why this organic compound cannot show tautomerism. Now we will study few examples, that is why we can understand about the tautomerism. First example, CH3CHO, acetaldehyde, this is the keto form, and its enol form is CH2 double bond CHOH, simply it is vinyl alcohol. This is known as enol form. Alkene in and alcohol all, that is why it is known as enol form. Another example, CH3COCH3 acetone or propane 2-on, according to IUPAC, it should not be written. Propanone is keto form and its enol form is prop 1-in-2-ol. Now another example, cyclohexanone, which is keto form and its enol form is having this structure, cyclohex 1-in-1-ol. Now we will understand enolism, or say keto enol tautomerism, in acidic medium as well as in basic medium. Keto-enol tautomerism in acidic medium. Keto-enol tautomerism in acidic medium. We have a ketone, say butane 2-on, or any other ketone we can take, R, CH2COOR. Let us take example of butane-2-1 and understand how tautomerism takes place in acidic medium. First of all, here we have non-bonding electron pair that attracts H plus. So next structure will be H has joined with oxygen. Now another attack with H2. So this bond will be migrated between carbon-carbon atom, and hydrogen will gain this electron pair and will form final structure which is enol structure. Once more we will understand CH3CH2COCH3, attack of H plus means acidic medium. This electron pair will be attracted towards H and H will be joined with oxygen, and simultaneously we can see that the bond between carbon and hydrogen, which is also alpha hydrogen, is attracted towards carbon-carbon bond, and this bond will become double bond. So this bond has to shift. This bond has to shift, and we will get the final structure CH3CH, double bond COH, CH3. This is known as enol form. This is keto form. Now we will study keto-enol tautomerism in basic medium. Keto-enol tautomerism in basic medium. CH3CH2C double bond OCH3 plus OH minus. First of all, CH2 alpha hydrogen, if we write it as this alpha hydrogens, one of this hydrogen will get this lone pair and join with OH minus, and this bond will be shifted here. Same time the bond between carbon and oxygen will be shifted to oxygen. So the structure obtained will be CH3CH double bond C, oxygen single bond having negative charge, and CH3. Now on the next reaction, this hydrogen will give bond to oxygen, so it will be OH minus. And this hydrogen, by taking electron pair from oxide minus, will attach, and the final structure obtained is of enol structure. Now another thing that is necessary to understand for tautomerism is sometimes enol form is more stable than keto form. In maximum cases, keto form is more stable than enol form because of bond energy value. We have to remember here that bond energy value of keto form is higher than that of enol form, and because of that reason keto form are generally more stable than enol form. But as I told that in some cases enol form becomes stable than keto form. Let's take example of acetyl acetone. First of all, we will understand the structure of acetyl acetone. We know the structure of acetone, CH3COCH3. On both the side of ketone we have methyl group. If one hydrogen of any methyl group is replaced by COCH3 group, then the compound so formed will be known as acetyl acetone. So the structure of acetyl acetone will be, structure of acetyl acetone is CH3CO, CH2CO, CH3. So here we have got active methyl group or methylene group. Active methylene group. It is not methyl because only CH2, that is why it is active methylene group. Now what happens? This is a keto form. Its enol form is CH3COH, double bond CH, C double bond O, CH3. So this is enol form. Let us understand why enol form is more stable, having 76% existence, and this is less stable, having existence only 24%. The reason behind this is, we can see that lone pair of oxygen of other ketone atom will be supplied towards hydrogen of OH group, and there we will be the possibility of intramolecular H bond. So because of intramolecular H bond, the stability of enol form becomes more than keto form. Beside with this, we have to remember that tautomerism is applicable to planar or non-planar structure, as well as we have to remember that tautomers are two different compounds. They are not the same compound. Thank you.